Hi, welcome back to Mr. CZ Bike. Today is going to be a video of the worst screw-ups and the most times my equipment messed up on me. I went out for a hot bike ride, and it's been the hottest part of the year so far. This is day 3 or 4 where the temperature's been at least in the 100 and teens. The hottest I saw was 125 degrees. And we're gonna get to see how well the Philodo H8 does in the heat. Does the battery hold up? How do the rest of the electronics hold up? And since I'm talking about the H8, I'm working on getting a coupon code. The coupon code should be Mr. C's e-bike. And I'm going to put it down below in the description. And in order to use the coupon, you have to go to, you don't click any of the bubbles under add to cart. You just add to cart and then go through like you're buying it. When it gets to the payment stage, there'll be a box to put your coupon code in. Like I said, it's $125 off. And since you don't click the button on the first page to get the $100 off, it's actually only $25 off more than it would have been. But if you can get an extra $25 off, why not? And I'll put it in the description, and hopefully by the time this video is up, it'll be working. And since I'm talking about the H8, we'll go over it again.
Right, this is my beat up dirty H8. But it's a all-wheel drive, 2,000 watt, 48 volt, 200 amp hour, 20 amp hour battery. And it'll go 30 miles on throttle only. It's got a 100 watt motor in the back, a 100 watt motor in the front. If you want to know more about it, check out. And as far as I know, I'm the only one with the $125 off coupon. So, but I mean, if somebody else has a better coupon or you can save money on a different site, go there. Don't use my link. But if you do buy the bike and use my coupon, use my link, because I do get like $80. All right, this seems like as good a place as any to start the ride. And I think I'm going to put the temperature up here somewhere. Of inside my house when I left, actually 5 minutes before I left, because I took the picture and got ready and whatever. And that's the temperature of the ground. I've been off my seat for a little while. That's the temperature of my seat. And I've got my beautiful wife at home taking pictures of the thermometer in the house. I'm going to be putting up like every half an hour, because this isn't the hottest part of the day. Just about, but. And I got to stop for just the stupid camera. Oh yeah, it's like a big hair dryer.
Wow, my mouth is so dry already. I gotta stop and get a piece of gum. That's way too dry. I don't know what the humidity is out here. Like 15%? Oh, come on. If you remember, I pulled my seat off for the Swagatron video. Oh, this is all different. I don't have no idea when this got wet. Even with my sunglasses on, this is just drying out my eyeballs. I think I said it was 122 when I left the house, and that's in the shade. Heading towards Ridgecrest. I'm not sure if this is quite what they call the buttermilk area, but this is like if you held a hairdryer to your arm and let it sit there until it was way too hot, put it your whole body. I'm not sweating. It's just hot. I think I gotta bleed my back brakes again. Got plenty of brakes, but it's all at the end of my lever. Time I stop, I'm gonna clip my helmet on. Every once in a while the helmet's getting hit by the end of the strap and it's either gonna fall off or at the very least it's messing with the audio. enough? I think I almost should put my gloves on. Just from the hot wind blowing at me.
I say that it's not hot and while you're riding, it's when you stop is when you start to break a sweat. But this is ridiculous. It's a whole different thing. The difference between 105 and 120, 125 is huge.
Taking it nice and slow today. The last thing I need to do is be laying out here in the middle of nowhere on the ground that's 160 degrees. But the batteries and the motors and the bike seems to be working fine in the heat. Now, I really didn't like the cold, but I guess it doesn't have much problem with the heat. Although the controllers probably aren't happy. They're doing their job. Jeez. Frickin' people. They don't even go off the road to dump. They sit here in the middle of the road and dump their crap. Not that going off the road is any better, but they're bad people, bad neighbors, and they're too lazy to leave the road.
Jeez, my hands, look at that. Man.
Wow. Just went to adjust my helmet. And that's pretty freaking hot, too. Oh, what do we got there? There's the cement factory. So I know about how close I'm getting. I think that's the cement factory anyways. That's what it looks like, but I didn't cross. No, Jack's Ranch yet. Unless this is it right here. And it looks close to the plant. Man. Bumps, bumps, bumps. Even when you take it easy, this is rough.
I've got the pressure down on my tires. I've got 15 in the front and 10 in the back. Although I'm sure from going from inside to outside, the pressure has changed. Wow. Yeah, this is Jack's Ranch. Wow. Not even many people out driving in the heat.
Usually I would have had to wait for two or three cars and then ran out in front of another. And most of my body is fine except for that heat. My head and this helmet is starting to sweat. My eyes are already starting to burn a little bit from the heat and being dried out. Glad I turned this down to pedal assist too. Fastest I can go is about 20 miles an hour and two. Which I don't know if taking it easy is just making it worse. Usually I come through here at 30 miles an hour with my ass set all the way back off to the back of the seat, and I don't think it's this bad. But I think I'm coming up to asphalt. Oh, hey, it's got a lot of fridges. I can't tell you how hot my hands are. I'm not really sure why. It's almost to the point where, like, you're getting something out of the oven and you're quick, so before it burns the hair off of your arms. Except I can't be quick. My brakes are really getting soft. Not even hitting 32 miles an hour. Oh, freaking hot. handicapped accessible. I can't even get on the sidewalk. Little bit of shade.
Let's see. Here. That's almost 3:30. My wife should be taking a temperature in about 10 minutes. It's 159.5 if you guys can't see it, because I can't see the camera. Here in the shade, well, only like 107 in the shade. I don't know if this brick has gotten any sun yet.
I don't know if I said it when I stopped, but that was downs. I thought it, but I don't know if it came out of my mouth. Coming up on Norma Street. By Albertsons.
So I had to look. Wow, sweaty, sweaty in the helmet. Come on, light. It's too hot to be sitting here. Wow.
Well, at least this one, there's a little shade. Oh, that's so much cooler. That guy's been stuck behind me since the last street, or the last intersection. I didn't know this is where I was going. Just went straight through town and out the other side. It's the back of the old Kmart. The hell? And they tell you you can park here if you have a wheelchair, but there's no ramp. You gotta go all the way out into the frickin' main strip of the parking lot and around here to get to the ramp. Who the hell thought that up? From the direction of the shadows from the trees, I should have went down the back of the store. Oh man, I was hoping it was going to be so much cooler back here. Going to take a quick temperature of my helmet. I hope you can see it. It's 130 degrees. Wow, I touched the side of my phone that's taking the video. And I think it's pretty hot too. Sorry, the camera's gonna get all wacky because I gotta take a drink. Well, I just took a picture of my other camera that I was using to record. That said temperature's too high to use the camera, so I'm kind of waiting for it to cool down. I'm going to try to use this one for a while and then switch back when this one gets too high. Oh, that camera is all, the phone is all split open so the breeze can blow right through it and it just overheated. But it is freaking hot out. All right, I'm going to try to connect this to my helmet and see how long this lasts. All right. See how long this one lasts. Someday I'll actually get an action camera or something. Maybe.
Actually, I've never come through here before, so. I know the park is over here somewhere. Right there's the baseball diamond, maybe, with the lights. I'm not really sure what you're seeing because I can't see the camera. Yeah, let me stop and see if I can figure it out. Sheesh. Every time I stop, it gets hotter and hotter. Man, if it wasn't so hot. Here's the skateboard. That's tiny. It's hard to even move something this big in there. Well, if there's some people out here. I don't know if it's by choice, but. Now with one phone down, I don't even know what times I should stop and take a measurement. Oh, temperature. Oh yeah. Still, I can't see anything that you guys are seeing. But I don't think you're tipped up enough. I look down, I won't even know if I'm still recording. Oh, I want to go through this intersection, but I don't want to wait for that light. Come on. Come on. It's too hot for this. Ah. Oh. That's it. Well, I've had my second camera overheat on me. And I think I'm just heading home because there's no point in doing this if I can't record it other than 20 minutes at a time. But it's now getting close to 2 o'clock. Or no, it's getting close to 3 o'clock. He's dry. And I'm going to head back home. Going to try to post the temperatures over here. And see if I can get home without this overheating. Boy, it's warm. Gotta get moving. Oh shit, I should have went the other way. Yeah. Hopefully the sidewalk's clear. I'll just turn at the next intersection. So many roads to nowhere here. Little shade. Hope the camera lasts almost all the way home. Hope I'm not just talking to myself and the camera's running now, because I can't tell. North Sanders. Nobody coming. I could just get the sweat from inside my helmet to run down the phone and cool it. Up to normal. Not waiting for that light or hitting that jump. Wow. Yeah, the forecast for today set to stay home. And if you're smart, that's what you're gonna do. Least handicap accessible city in the world.
downs. Heat stroke. I'm gonna go into the Dollar General where there's AC. Cool off for a minute. They're always pretty nice in there. Mr. C back on the road after a quick pit stop at the Dollar General. The people here are always nice in there. They don't hassle me about bringing my bike in. One of them even told me I could park it behind the register so nobody messed with it. Anyways, I feel much better after a pit stop. And hopefully my camera will last all the way home. It's about 4 o'clock now, which is supposed to be the hottest part of the day. But like I said, I'm just going to try to get home. Because I can't keep recording when the cameras keep dying because of the heat. out where this car is going. So I don't know where I'm going either, but gonna get out of here. These are the little streets that you turn down, and this one's a cul-de-sac, that one's at that end, this one just circles back around to the cul-de-sac. Back up to Downs. Well, this is the camera that made it all the way down into town and then around a little bit before it overheated, so hopefully it'll make it all the way home. So I'm just gonna go straight down the highway. Even if it doesn't, you guys don't need to see me going straight down the highway for 15 minutes or however long it takes me. I got 7 miles of this, and about a mile of sand road, and I'm home. But I imagine this is going to be hotter than the back road, so maybe my camera won't make it. Oh, crap. I don't know if it's the buckle of my belt or the snap on my shorts, but something's getting pretty hot. And I drank a whole bottle of water at the Dollar General while I was resting up, cooling down. So I should be fairly hydrated. But my mouth and my eyes are so dry. And my hands are starting to get hot again. Guy won't share his air conditioning. I'm telling you, this is almost unbearably hot. I can't even explain it. My thumbs are starting to feel like they're just too hot to hang on to my handle grips. Set my cruise control. Oh, fuck you. Went to set my cruise control and shut my bike off. All right, gotta build speed up again. He's so much class and shit. Cruise control. There we go. Now I can move my hands around when they get too hot. I don't know if I'm yelling too loud or if you can hear me at all. I can see the recording dot or button or whatever the hell it is. So I know the camera's still recording so far. Holy crap. I weighed myself before I left. I'm going to weigh myself when I get back. I was thinking I'd lose about 3 pounds just in sweat. But I just downed that whole bottle of water. In like, I don't know, 10 minutes. So I don't know how much that's going to offset it. I get quiet, that's because I'm just kind of getting into the zone where I'm not feeling all this heat or everything drying out. Just because it's so damn hot. I put my hands down onto my shorts and the shorts are hot. Now 4:14. So if my wife's taking pictures of the thermometer every half an hour, I should have a picture of how hot it is.
All right, as you can tell, the battery died, and well, actually my phone overheated. I got home about 4:30. I'll put the time and temp up here. And it's just freaking hot out. Neither one of my phones wanted to keep working the video. My battery didn't seem to last as long. My motors started making weird noises. My brakes started making weird noises. And I'm just going to go jump on the scale so I have my next weight. Then I'm going to jump in the shower. Thanks for watching.